total scam. Like, that is a scam. Hi everyone, today I'm going to be speaking to you about the sample beauty palettes and why I think they're a total scam. Now, this is my personal opinion and I would really like to know your opinion in the comments section. A few days ago, my friend bought me these two eyeshadow palettes from Sample Beauty on Instagram, and I had never heard of this brand before, so I had no idea what these were going to look like. I had a feeling that they were going to be bright colours because that's all I really wear, and my friend has got the best taste in makeup ever. Possibly even better taste than me. The palettes that he got me were the Hydrographic and the Immensity palette, and these come in a set of four called the Quad Squad. These are £20 each, or you can get all four for £70. Personally, I think that £20 for 10 shades is too much, but as I said, my friend bought me these and he's not stingy like I am. Before I even opened these, I thought to myself, I really like the packaging on this. It's simple and functional, and to be honest, that's all you need. I work in a shop that sells makeup and I'm so sick of going in every day and seeing the eyeshadow palettes with glitter all over them, or they're holographic, and there's one called Find Your Sparkle, and when you open it up, it's all neutrals that's in it. I don't understand this new trend. All the holographic packaging and all the names that say Glitter Queen and Glitter Princess, and then you open it up and it's all browns, and they're not even sparkly, they're not glitter, nothing, they're just neutral and crap. And I don't understand why they're making the packaging like this. If I was the sort of person who liked neutral colours, I wouldn't go into a shop and pick up a glittery palette that said Find Your Sparkle. It just doesn't make any sense. But anyway, I'm getting off track here. I think that this packaging is really nice and it obviously reminds me of Morphe packaging. It doesn't have to be too fancy. To me, it's the product that counts. The first palette that I opened was the Immensity palette, and as you can see, the sleeve is exactly the same as the palette. I know that that doesn't really matter to a lot of people because they just throw these away, but personally I like to keep them. When you first open this palette, it's got the little plastic protector inside, and I think this has got a really good size of mirror. I actually used the mirror today when I was doing this eye look, and when I first seen this I thought, wow, those colours are stunning. I love the order that they're in, I like the names of them, and I hadn't swatched them yet, but I was really impressed with the colours. And I thought, you know, if these eyeshadows are good, maybe this eyeshadow palette will be worth £20. So then I opened up the other palette, which is the Hydrographic palette. Again, you have the plastic protector in the mirror, everything's exactly the same. And I know that a lot of people might be more impressed with the Immensity palette, but if you know me, you'll know that I love blue eyeshadow. And I like to wear it with purple as well, so that's what I'm wearing today. I'm actually wearing this colour and this colour today. Now obviously I'm not a makeup artist, I just really like to wear eyeshadow, and blue and purples are my favourites. So this eyeshadow palette was really blowing my mind. And this colour here, Fuck Plastic, which I have on my eyes right now, oh my god, like I just think this colour is absolutely stunning. I'm going to swatch this quickly on my hand here, but in a second I'm going to be swatching all the colours to show you why I think that these palettes are a scam. But this colour here is just amazing. It's just so beautiful. I love the fact that they've got these colours that are basically the same, but these ones are matte and these ones are shimmer. And I always say that when I'm putting on eyeshadow, I like to have the exact same colour in a matte and a shimmer. And that's why I use both the Take Me Back to Brazil palettes. I just think that it makes the eyeshadow stand out more when you've got the different textures. As I was admiring my new gifts, I swatched these two blues and I literally just put my fingers in like this and swiped them on the back of my hand, and I could not get the colours off my fingertips. It totally stained them. Now I used makeup remover, cleanser, everything, and it just wasn't removing the blues. But when I went onto their Instagram to see if these were pressed pigments, they said that they're just eyeshadows. But as you'll find out in a minute, not everything that they say can be trusted. So I took both palettes and I put them side by side to kind of try and envision an eye look that I could do. And it's pretty obvious to me straight away. And I mean, I must have been looking at these palettes for about 2 minutes before I realised the problem here. Take a look and see what you think. Now, as I said, I'm not a makeup artist, but it's so blatantly obvious to me that there's a problem here. Basically, this entire bottom row is exactly the same as the colours that are mixed in with this other palette. Now, since these come in the same collection called the Quad Squad, I think that that is absolutely ridiculous, and I think it's a scam. What I'm going to do is swap over cameras, and I'm going to swatch all of these colours, but I'm also going to swatch the bottom row of these with the colours in here that are exactly the same, side by side, to give you an idea of how identical these are, and then I'll be back in just a minute. To begin with, I'll swatch the top row of the Immensity palette. I'll come back to this row later. I'm going to be swatching this on a dry, clean arm with no base and doing one swipe swatches. This is what the top row looks like. I don't know if it's really picking up on camera, but these look really chalky. However, as we know, finger swatches don't really mean much, and it's how they apply on the eye that really matters. I'm really loving the orange and red colours, and I'm quite disappointed with the yellow, but yellows are usually disappointing. Before I move on to the bottom row of this palette, I'm also going to bring in the Hydrographic palette. Basically, this entire bottom row is in this palette as well. I'm going to do single swipe swatches, and I'm going to be putting these ones on the left and these ones on the right. These will be mixed in. Once I've done that, I'll come back and show you the rest of the colours. These are the colours side by side. As I said before, the ones on the left are from the Immensity palette and the ones on the right are from the Hydrographic palette. Now, there's no denying that these colours are exactly the same. I will say that this green colour, the one on the left, is slightly different, possibly one shade darker, but these ones are all identical. When a girl asked them on Instagram if the shades were the same, they said that Dory and Momentous were almost identical. This is Dory and Momentous. This dark blue in the middle here. Now, that's not almost identical, that is actually identical. Look at this colour here, it's got the same shimmer through it. The blues are exactly the same. Those greens are touching, and you would think that those are the same eyeshadow. So when I messaged them, they said that they did duplicate the shades, but when a girl asked on Instagram, they said that it was only this shade that was almost identical. So they're just compulsive liars. Once again, these shades look really chalky. However, I used this on my eyes today and I didn't experience any problems with it at all. It was a little bit difficult to build up to start off with, but I didn't have any fallout and I didn't feel as if it felt chalky when it was going on the eyes. So maybe these ones will be the same when you apply them with a brush. Let's look at the rest of the colours in the Hydrographic palette. The colours that we're left with in the Hydrographic palette are these, and I'm just going to be swatching these the same as the others. These are the final swatches, and for some reason I was having a lot of trouble picking up Ursula, but this second colour in is called Fuck Plastic, and I think this is absolutely stunning. Every time I look at this palette, I just keep looking at that colour, it's blown my mind. The second colour in from the right is called Typhoon, and I think that's beautiful as well. I don't think the camera is picking up these shimmers as well as it could, except Ursula, because I don't know what the deal is with that, it just doesn't seem to want to work. But this Fuck Plastic colour is just stunning! I wanted you to see what these shimmers looked like when applied with a wet finger, because when I applied Fuck Plastic today, I applied it with a wet brush and oh wow. So I just wet my finger and this is what they look like on the other side of my arm. Ah, how beautiful is that? Like, I wish I could just have a full palette just with that one colour. That is amazing. Let me know in the comment section what your favourite colour was. Here's a quick recap of the names. Of course, if you pick any of these colours, then I'll assume that you like the colours that's in this palette as well, because they're identical. After I swatched the colours and realised how similar they were, I says to my friend, there's no way that I'm the only person who's noticed these are the same. So I went onto YouTube to watch some reviews, and I watched Tammy Clark and LSG Makeup, and none of them even mentioned that the colours are repeated, which is totally bizarre to me, because these two people are either makeup artists or they professionally do makeup on YouTube, so you would think it was something that they would mention. LSG Makeup done a look where she put tape down her eyes and done like three separate looks together. So she used a lot of the colours in the palettes and she still didn't mention that they were repeated. She also had an affiliate link code, so I don't know if that's why she's not mentioned it, but I found it a bit dodgy. So I was totally disgusted at this point, and I went on Instagram to see if anybody had commented that the shades were the same. In the comments, a girl actually asked if the blues repeated throughout the palette, and they replied that Dory and Momentous were almost identical. Now, you've seen the swatches for yourself. You know fine well that Dory and Momentous aren't the only colours that are almost identical. So I messaged them and sent them this picture and said that the two lime greens were almost identical, but these other four colours are actually identical, so why are they lying to this girl? And they admitted to me that they duplicate the colours throughout the palettes. And I says, this is unacceptable. Like, is that even legal? I understand that there's only so many colours that you can have. And I know that people buy eyeshadow palettes from Morphe and they say, oh, this colour's really similar to the one in the James Charles palette or whatever. But they have got a lot of palettes. And Sample Beauty are selling these four palettes as a quad. Like, the quad squad, it's one collection and they've put the same colours in it. They said to me, some of the colours duplicate across palettes. Each palette has its own colour story. Now, that doesn't make it any better. I was trying to say to them, you've basically got one collection of eyeshadows, you've took the exact same colours, put them into another eyeshadow palette and changed the name of them. Just because it's got a different colour story doesn't make it okay to use the same colour, especially when it's in the same collection. And they were messaging me saying, oh, we don't want to fall out with anybody, we're only a one person business and all the rest of it. Now, I'm sorry, I don't care how many people's in your business, I don't care if it's one or 1,000, you can't just put the same colours in a different palette of the same collection and change the name. It's a total scam. Like, that is a scam. Then they said the colours are named in relation to the palette theme, not the colour itself. Now, I understand that, but what I'm trying to say is you can't have one collection with four palettes and then just put the same colours in a different palette and give it a different name. Like, that is a scam to me. I think that if you had to contact Trading Standards, they would say that that's unacceptable and they would have to pay some sort of fine or something. And they says to me, what is it you want us to do? Do you want to send the palettes back? Now, I didn't want to send the palettes back, but I think that at the very least, they should have refunded at least a third of the money, because a third of the eyeshadows are exactly the same as what I've already got. When I asked them why they lied to the girl who asked if the colours repeated, they says that they were honest because the formula and those two colours are different, but they came out almost identical. But they didn't mention the fact that the other colours are actually identical, so they're just compulsive liars. I said to them, I think that you should disclaim to your customers that when you buy the quad squad, some of the colours are going to be repeated. And they were just like, oh, you can send the palettes back or we'll give you a refund. And I'm like, you're not understanding what I'm saying. You're scamming your customers. And I want you to disclaim that the colours are repeated. I don't think that that's too much to ask. As I mentioned before, I used the Hydrographic palette to do this eye look today. And I'm not a makeup artist, but I think it looks quite nice. And both these palettes, Fuck Plastic is definitely my favourite colour. And I don't have another blue like this in my collection. And trust me, I've got a lot of eyeshadows. I don't want people out there to think that I'm just totally bashing Sample Beauty and telling them not to buy the products, because there was a lot of positives about these, but I just think it was a complete scam to be given the same colours with different names in the same collection. Let me know in the comments section if you agree. I'm also wondering why those two YouTubers didn't mention the fact that these colours were even similar, never mind duplicated. It's just so strange to me. I think that the girl who's got the affiliate code must have noticed that the colours were identical because she was using so many colours on her eyes. It just wouldn't make any sense for her to not notice it. I mean, have you got to a point where if somebody gets PR or if somebody has got an affiliate code that they're not going to be honest with you about the product? Because I feel as if that's how YouTubers are going these days. It's just constant lies. I watch a channel called Make Me Up Missa, and I've mentioned her before, but she's not a trained makeup artist and she is so good at doing makeup. I actually love watching her videos and she's so honest all the time, and she gets a lot of negative comments from people asking her why she's being negative, and I think she's not being negative, she's just being honest, and I wish that more YouTubers were like that. I really wish that Make Me Up Missa would review these two palettes because then she would show you how similar these are, and maybe people would actually listen to her, because let's face it, nobody's going to be listening to me. Let me know in the comments section if you've used sample beauty products before, and if you've had any similar problems. Also, let me know in the comments section if you think this is a scam. I just think it's totally unacceptable. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you're new here, consider subscribing. If you're interested in seeing future videos, hit the notification bell so that you're notified as soon as I upload a video. If you would like to see any of my other videos, I'll leave a playlist around here somewhere, and thanks for watching. Bye! The palettes that he got me were the Immensity palette and the Hydrographic palette. For God's sake. This is just one of these times where it's going to take me an hour to film a video because everybody in the street's now making noise again. I can't believe this is happening to me again. There's somebody taking a bin out. Oh my God! There's about five people outside cutting the grass now. As you can see, the two of these have got the same packaging and they look almost identical. Now the seagulls are out hunting for their dinner. Honestly, I can't even cope with this anymore. I can't cope with this noise. It's driving me insane. Right, let's try that again. I'm never going to get this video finished. I've got the windows closed and you can hear everybody out there cutting the grass. I must move to a secluded area. It's the only chance I stand.